30-year-old Rebecca Munyensi, a student at St. Francis Secondary School in Kawempe, last week on Friday pleaded guilty to charges related to impersonation for conniving with a school headmistress, Mili Nanteza, to procure the services of Asuman Chidauli to write UCE exams on her behalf in a deal that cost the student 2.5 million shillings. Appearing before the Grade 1 magistrate Christian Chivuka at Naweru Court today, Munyensi has been sentenced to 2 months in prison or pay a fine of 200,000 shillings. According to the magistrate, considering the future of the student and her remorsefulness, jailing her for 2 months was appropriate.
We appeared in court before the magistrate and he gave his sentence. The sentence was either 2 months in jail or a fine of 200,000. The reasons advanced by the magistrate were that she did not waste court's time, she pleaded guilty. And secondly, that she had wasted a lot of time. She had spent a lot of time on remand. She had already lost a year. The fact that she cannot proceed with her exams means that she has lost a year. That is also a punitive enough. Thirdly, that her parents have already lost a lot of money on her school fees, which they cannot recover.
The state prosecution, led by the UNEB legal team, was however not satisfied with the sentence, saying that it was very light given the nature of the case. With the primary leaving examinations just in the corner, they went ahead to warn schools, parents and students against evolving in exam malpractice.
True that court is moving these matters expeditiously because we want judgment to be delivered immediately so that it has an impact. We have PLE coming. And that is one of the most difficult examinations to administer. The rate of malpractice is very high. The urge to do malpractice is very high, especially for commercial reasons. And in the process, they end up hurting these children. There's physical, where you would mislead a child with the wrong papers. There's that mental destruction that you have given to the child. The child will never feel confident that this was his work.
They are going to commission the PLE examination, which will effectively start on Monday, the 7th of November, with a briefing of candidates. Then on Tuesday, the candidates will begin writing with mathematics in the morning and SST in the afternoon. We want to urge the head teachers to please do their bit and make sure they go ahead and they brief the candidates. It's very important for them to brief the candidates, because once you brief the candidates, then they know what tantamounts to malpractice. They know how to behave during the examination season, because we realize that many malpractice cases happen because the candidates were not briefed, were not told what they need to do and what they don't need to do.
The same court has set 5th December to start hearing the case in which the school headmistress is accused of aiding the convicted student to hire another person to sit for her exams. The accused headmistress, Mili Nanteza, today turned up for the case mentioned. Report compiled by Juliet Namwaya for the news.